I would say, I came to be a student in the film school in the 1960s, in the late 1960s. And that was a time of enormous change in the Netherlands, in cultural change. So my sort of the three things that really interested me at the time were film and jazz and semiotics. And semiotics came in, I started reading Roland Barthes and so on while at film school. And we started a magazine where we wrote about that. And so already at that time, my interest in semiotics existed. But what was going to be the mainstream in my life was not yet quite clear. So the other side to that story, as I've sort of gradually come to think about it, is that I was then engaging in things that were very different from the background and the milieu that I came out of. I'm a son of a Protestant minister. Images were barely any images in our house at all. There are no images in the churches. So in a way, that choice was a choice to go a different direction from how I initially grew up. And I do remember that. I loved my father very much, but he was very full of praise when I wrote poems and published some poems. When he saw my first film that I made in the first year at film school, he looked at it and he said it was rather superficial. And I was deeply hurt. It was a film which actually won two prizes. It was not a bad film. It was a portrait of a friend of mine. So sometimes I think that this whole idea that was already in my head at the time of, coming from, if you like, a logocentric world, to want to say images are like this as well. Film is also, is as good as the idea of the language of image or the language of the film attracted me enormously. And these sort of French filmmakers like Chris Marker and so on, who talked about, the camera stylo, the film as writing, doing intellectual work with it, that fascinated me enormously. And at that time, and much to the dismay of one of my most revered and best teachers, who thought it was risky and to be so intellectually interested and might harm my creativity, which I've always been very, very much against. I've always believed that the mind and the emotions are not in each other's way at all and can be combined, and creativity and thought can be combined.